Welcome to the Monterey software release. It's our 13th free software update, and we're proud of what's gone into it. Obviously, a lot of attention to detail has gone into bringing BenchPilot online. So BenchPilot brings full automation to Origin in a way that's familiar to existing Origin users. And as you all know, it's very easy to become familiar with Origin. People can go from creating shapes to fully automated cutting operations in a few seconds. In fact, we'll get into that in a second and show you exactly how that works. Beyond that, there's a bunch of features that actually positively impact all existing owners. We'll just walk through some of the top-level notes. Encoded depths are now visualized on screen. This affects everyone, not just BenchPilot users. They also behave a lot more intuitively. So I think you're all going to enjoy the boost you get from encoded depth improvements. There's now a transfer button. So this takes in an encoded depth you're hovering over and sets that to your tool depth. Just a little quality of life improvement. And of course, jump on shapertools.com/Monterey for more information. There'll be thorough documentation there, but we're gonna get into the details now and walk you through the basics of how to put it to use. So here we are in the Monterey release. We're looking at a regular Origin with no AutoPass active, no BenchPilot active. So this is what everyone will benefit from here. So we're gonna look at how encoded depths work. At the moment, we got three circles. These were just created on tool. None of them have any depth encodings, and there's a little perimeter cut as well. So I'm gonna set a depth encoding for this guy, for the center one. So click on depth, and then encoded depth is available. So we'll go 0.75. Now that encodes the depth of the center one. So now we see our depth called out. So this item under our cursor that's highlighted green is encoded at 0.75. So let's change the adjacent one. We can now click on the screen. We can click on the little call out and go and directly set our encoded depth. 1 inch, done. So that's pretty handy. Now we've got two different encoded depths, and I'll set this one to a shallower depth. Notice at the moment, our tool is saying, hey, have at it. Cut down to your tool depth, and we're not gonna give you any indication there is a problem. So if I set this to 0.25, we're gonna see some things change. So now we're seeing, okay, we wanna cut to 1/2 inch, but this is encoded to 1/4 inch. So that makes sense that it's giving us a warning. In this state, it's not gonna stop us and still cut that. It's just giving you a heads up. Oh, by the way, you're trying to cut deeper. Now, if I take this outside one and set it to an encoded depth of 0.5, you'll see now it's telling us, oh, by the way, you're cutting to exactly the depth you intend. So that's the three different states of this button and how the little callout behaves in this mode. So if I'm hovering over nothing, it's just showing my tool depth. If I'm hovering over something with an encoded depth shallower than my tool depth, it's going to warn me. So I get the little orange exclamation mark. Anything else will be just a generic kind of, you are welcome to cut to this depth. You're not going to reach your intended depth, but you're not gonna do harm. You're not gonna cut material you don't intend to. You can see that for the 3/4 inch and 1 inch one. And then for something that you're cutting to the exact depth, you'll see that called out there. So one more thing that's kind of fun. So let's say this 1 inch one is encoded to something strange. So I'm just gonna go encoded depth 0.175. Not that strange, but let's say now I want to cut something else to that depth. I want to update my tool depth. Historically, you've had to go in here and type that in. So I'd have to type this in. Look down here though, we have this transfer button. So what that's saying is I can take my encoded depth and just make that my tool depth. So boom. Now our tool depth is 0.175. That saves us the issues of, you know, entering data, missing a decimal, missing a value. So yeah, that tidies up that process a lot. So that's available outside of AutoPass. But now let's look at what happens when AutoPass is active. So now for all the AutoPass users, when you first activate AutoPass, you're gonna see how many passes it's going to take to cut down to that depth. We're using an 8mm cutter and all of our depth encodings are respected. So you'll see here, you're always cutting to the tool depth. It's gonna update and just get you that tool depth every time. And then the other thing you'll notice, when I move off a path, my tool depth reverts to whatever the tool depth was previously. So that means anything that's unencoded will be cut to that depth, but everything that is encoded will be cut to its encoded depth. So you'll notice this one's just one pass, this one's three passes, all the passes are being automatically generated with offsets, you know, passes, the individual pass depth, and the whether or not you have a roughing pass and what that offset is all called out there, ready to go. Now, In this mode, the tool depth is constantly responding and updating to the encoded depth. So that makes sense in most cases, but then there's sometimes where it's like, okay, I've got a file and I actually just want to cut it all at 0.5 inches. So how do we do that? We just edit the tool depth. So if you just change your tool depth, it's going to give you a little call out saying, hey, I'm no longer updating based on my depth encoding. So now you'll see this is no longer a green tick. So we're in that secondary state. It's still going to use, you know, it's going to cut in passes down to this depth, not to this depth. So if you see this not showing a green tick, you're probably in this mode where you're just overriding the tool depth. This one happened to match. So the half inch of my tool depth matches the encoded depth. But all these other ones, it's saying, hey, you sure you want to cut to half an inch? You're going to cut deeper than this. And this one's saying, this is encoded to 0.75. You're not going to get to the full depth. You're sure you want to cut to 0.5. And likewise, this one, 0.175. So if you want to then re-enable auto updating, you just disable auto pass, turn it back on. And now you'll see this will be constantly updating to a green tick. So that's how to override any encoded depths if they are proving to be onerous. So now we're going to bring in BenchPilot, and it's going to add some more capabilities to the mix.
If you don't own AutoPass, BenchPilot still comes with all the settings you need to perform cuts in multiple passes.
AutoPass presents a little differently. It's doing a lot more sophisticated work under the hood. Basically, it's creating tool paths for pockets. It's doing all of your passes down to your encoded depth. So in that way, it's a little bit like AutoPass, but there's actually a lot more going on.
When you're clipped into BenchPilot, you're always going to have that feature available to you. When you unclip, those who own AutoPass will be able to do similar things using AutoPass. Those without AutoPass will have to manually enter their pass depths.
We keep that distinct to BenchPilot. So if you own BenchPilot, it's always going to handle your passes for you. So rest assured, BenchPilot's going to cut down to your intended depths, to your depth encodings, every time. It's also going to cut with the right parameters that you describe here, and it's going to cut in the right order. We try to order them in a way that makes sense. So it'll be online cuts, pocket cuts, inside cuts, and then outside cuts. And that usually gets you the best outcomes in that we don't cut an object loose before doing all the detail in the middle. So the outside cut's usually cutting something out, as it is in this case. Now, one thing to note is AutoPass, you can't override the encoded depth. Basically, AutoPass, if you have a depth encoded, that's the depth that's going to cut to. So all of these, you'll see the green tip pops up. That's the depth you're getting. You know, I can't type in here an arbitrary depth. It's always going to cut to the encoded depth. If, say, my perimeter has no encoded depth, then it's going to cut to the tool depth. And the tool depth remains static. So even if I roll over different values, the tool depth as I roll off remains 0.5. So that means anything with no encoded depth is getting cut to that depth, and everything else is getting cut to its encoded depth. So how does that look when I hit the preview cuts button? Very similar, but we get callouts here saying, hey, you've got mixed cut types, so it's not all the same cut. And you've also got mixed depths. So this is just a good screen. If you only want to cut to say 0.5 inches and you've got say, you know, 50 holes and this says mixed, that means something has the incorrect encoding. And then you just go back and just do a quick audit hovering over things. There might be one that's unset or doesn't have that depth call out. So that's it for the BenchPilot encoded depths. As you can see, very similar to the other modes, but just a couple of nuances to keep in mind there. So as always, we love hearing from you and seeing the projects you produce. You can tag us on Instagram, hashtag ShaperMade. And then there's the forum, community.shapertools.com. There's a huge crew of people all producing really interesting projects, interesting solutions. Get involved there. And then, of course, if you're ever struggling with anything or need some assistance from our team directly, support@shapertools.com. We're always here to help. I hope you enjoy Monterey.